On any given night here in Los Angeles, there are 6,000 homeless youth living on the street, and 40% are LGBT.
Yeah, and this year, the Los Angeles Police Department's LGBT Working Group is teaming up with the LA and the San Fernando Valley LGBT Centers to brighten the holidays of homeless youth with a donation drive.
Community liaison Jules Sohn is here to tell us about the new project that, I should say, Officer Jules Sohn is here to talk about this. First of all, why is this so important?
Well, first, thank you so much for having me here. Yeah. I feel so privileged to be able to speak about this drive. Clearly, there's such a need with the number of homeless youth that are on the streets on a daily basis. Mm-hmm. And this particular program was actually set up by our working group, which is predominantly community leaders within the LGBTQ community who have a clear desire to work with law enforcement to find different ways to address issues that are impacting the community. And so we feel very lucky that they brought this to us. They said, hey, we have a need. Homeless youth on the streets. The holidays are coming. Let's do something to help.
Why are the numbers so large?
So this particular 40% of homeless youth identify as LGBTQ. And this study was done by the Williams Institute back at UCLA. Mm. And what we're seeing is that oftentimes we're in a kind of in a bubble in LA where we have a lot of cultural acceptance towards the LGBTQ community, mm-hmm. but there are a lot of families that still struggle with that. And oftentimes the results of societal rejection results in some youth being put out on the street. Either they run away or they end up being kicked out.
Yeah.
What is the most important item you need to collect from people?
So we're doing two parts of this drive. So one is the food drive. So our San Fernando Valley LGBT Center is doing a holiday food drive. So we're looking at canned goods, things that are non-perishable, not expired, and please no glass.
Okay.
Just in terms of safety, in terms of putting in the box and for transport. The other piece that is important, especially for homeless youth, are socks. A lot of people mm-hmm. don't realize that the LA LGBT Center gets a lot of clothing donations. Mm. And one of the things that people sometimes forget are the comfort of new warm socks. Mm. And so that's part of the reason why we call it a sock, clothing, toy, and food drive.
And then in terms of clothing, so I have a bunch of stuff I'd like to, you know, possibly donate, but you know, some of my stuff are dresses and different things. Are you taking any capacity of clothes or?
So we're looking at lightly used clean clothing. Mm-hmm. There are different programs within the LA LGBT Center that actually does like job prep and
Great.
Things like that. So they do accept business attire mm-hmm. and dresses and things of that.
Okay,
so where can these donations be dropped off again?
So we have five different locations throughout the city of LA. We have two locations in downtown LA, so our headquarters and Central Bureau. We have a Valley Bureau location, West LA, as well as South LA.
Okay, great. So, Officer Sohn, thank you so much for bringing this to our attention. This donation drive will last through the 15th, the 13th of December. If you have questions, you can actually contact the LAPD Community Relationship Division. There is a phone number on the screen there. Also, how we found out about this was from Twitter, from the LAPD
yeah.
headquarters, so LAPD HQ. And then you and I are going to be talking on Facebook Live after the
yes,
show,
definitely.
Too, because I want to get into a little bit more detail talking about the LGBT community.
Figured out where you're going to do that yet?
Community. Somewhere. Okay. Somewhere around here.
All right.
Hey, always working yeah. girls.
Hey.
All right. Thank you, Officer.
Thank you so much.
Well,
the